The Life and Sad Ending of Henry Youngman. Henry Youngman was born March 16, 1906, in London, England, to a Jewish family. His family moved to Bay Ridge, Brooklyn, New York, when he was a child. He grew up in New York City and began as a comedian after he had worked for years at a print shop, where he wrote comedy cards containing one-line gags. The comedy cards were discovered by an up-and-coming comedian, Milton Berle, who encouraged Youngman and formed a close friendship with him. Encouraged by his family to study the violin, Youngman began in show business as a musician. He led a small jazz band called the Swanee Syncopators, and during performances, he often told jokes. One night, the club's regular comedian did not show up, and the owner asked Youngman to fill in. He enjoyed it and began his long career as a stand-up comic. His inoffensive, friendly style of comedy kept his audiences laughing for decades. He first played in clubs and speakeasies, but his big break came on Kate Smith's radio show in 1937. Youngman's manager, Ted Collins, booked him on the show, and he made many appearances on the radio. During the 1940s, Youngman tried to work in films as an actor, but he found little work in Hollywood. He returned to nightclubs and worked steadily, performing as many as 200 shows per year. Working with writer-producer Danny Shapiro, Youngman recorded The Primitive Sounds of Henry Youngman, a live album for National Recording Corporation in 1959 at the Celebrity Club in St. Louis. Youngman made numerous appearances on television, including a long-running stint on Rowan and Martin's Laughing. In 1955, he hosted a TV series entitled The Henry and Rocky Show, appearing with champion boxer Rocky Grisano. He had a cameo appearances in several movies, including Juan Tan Tan, The Dog Who Saved Hollywood, History of the World Part 1, and Goodfellas. Like many comedians, Henry Youngman treated his profession as a working job, one where making a living is difficult and getting paid for the work is all important. When the New York Telephone Company started its Dial-A-Joke in 1974, over 3 million people called in 1 month to hear Youngman's material, the most ever for a comedian. He had a larger role as the strip club owner in Herschel Goodwin Lewis's The Gore Gore Girls. He made a few recordings, most notably The Primitive Side of Henry Youngman, recorded live in St. Louis and released by National Recording Corporation on the NRC label. The CD is still in print. Youngman never retired, and he performed his stage act in venues worldwide until his final days. As his fame passed into legendary status, he never considered himself aloof or above others, and he never refused to perform a show in a small venue or unknown club. Youngman's last movie appearance before his death was in Daniel Robert Cohn's film Eyes Beyond Seeing, in which he has a cameo as a mental patient, claiming to be Henry Youngman. In his personal life, Youngman married Sadie Cohn in 1928. They had two children, Gary and Marilyn. They remained married for 59 years until Sadie's death in 1987 after a prolonged illness. With the exception of a week following his wife's death and the month he was in his final hospital stay, Youngman worked almost every day for over 70 years without vacations or other breaks. Sadly, Youngman developed pneumonia and died at Mount Sinai Medical Center in Manhattan on February 24, 1998, 3 weeks before his 92nd birthday. He was interred in the Mount Carmel Cemetery, Glendale, New York, next to his wife, Sadie.